must get out of this place at once! I allow no bunburying here!
I have put Mr. Worthing's things in the room next to yours, sir. I suppose this is all right.
What?
Mr. Earnest's luggage, sir. I have placed it in the room next to your own.
His luggage?
Yes, sir.
It's my door to my house. I'm going to get 2 handbow seats and a large luncheon basket.
Merriman, order the dog cart at once. Mr. Worthing has been suddenly called back to town.
Yes, sir.
What a beautiful liar you are, Jack! I have not been called back to town at all!
Yes, you have.
I haven't heard anyone call me. Your duty as a gentleman calls you back. My duty as a gentleman has never interfered with my pleasures in the smallest degree. I can quite understand that. Cecily is a darling. You are not to speak of Miss Cardew like that. I don't like it. Well, I don't like your clothes. You look perfectly ridiculous in them. Why on earth don't you go up and change? It's perfectly childish to be in deep mourning for a man who stayed in your house for a whole week as your guest. I call it pretext. You are certainly not staying with me for a whole week as a guest or as anything else. You have got to leave by the 4:05 train. I certainly won't leave you as long as you're in mourning. It would be very unfriendly. If I was in mourning, you would stay with me, I suppose. I think it very unkind if you wouldn't.
Well,
will you go if I change my clothes? Yes, if you're not too long. I've never seen anybody take so long with such little result. Well, at any rate, that's better than being always overdressed as you are. Well, if I'm occasionally a little overdressed, I always make up for it for being immensely overeducated. Your vanity is ridiculous. Your conduct is an outrage. Your presence in my garden is utterly absurd. However, you have got to leave by the 4:05 train. And I hope you will have a pleasant journey back to town. This bunbury, as you call it, has not been a great success for you. I think it has been a great success. I'm in love with Cecily, and that is everything. But I must see her before I go. Make arrangements for another bunbury. There she is.
Oh, I nearly came back to order the roses. I thought you were with Uncle Jack.
He's gone to order the dog cart for me.